Good morning, everyone. And we better start it up. It's 11:05, I think, or something like that. If you see flags coming around, this is Father's Day, so happy Father's Day. We normally have a gift. On Mother's Day, we always do a flower, usually something like a rose. And for the guys, it's like a little flashlight or a tire gauge or something cute. And this year, we ended up with these flags. So if you're a daddy, take a flag. And that's kind of a little thing between us and you. Let's stand up together and go into Scripture. Good place to start, good place to finish, and everything in between. I've been reading from chapter 2 of the book of Acts. I think this will be the fourth week, the day of Pentecost, which led to Peter's great sermon to the multitudes. I don't know what that was just now. Glitch in the computer. But anyway, the last part, the last six verses of this chapter are huge for us to emulate as a church. Because there's sometimes we might think, as Christians, your church folks, what do? We don't get it. We don't know what to do. So on, so forth. The model is here. Is there someone who's never led us before? Never led us before. That would be willing to do it? There's people trying to voluntell each other. I can hear that right now. All right, after the fight that broke out in the back, Victor's got it. Thank you, Victor. There were two ladies that are well good friends trying to tell each other to do it, but we'll keep them off of it.
They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship,
to the breaking of bread and to prayer.
Everyone was filled with awe at the many wonders and signs performed by the apostles.
All the believers were together and had everything in common, truly. And there'll be more to that scripture. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you so much for calling us into this place. We don't come except by your prevenient grace, calling on us, working on us ahead of time. Left to our own devices, there is no telling what we do, and most of us have done that in the past. But here we are. We thank you for this blessed morning. It's also our prayer that we come together in one mind and one accord and one belief. And one way that we can show that and underscore that belief is through saying together the Lord's Prayer. Let's do that now. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Let's stay standing. We've got a Father's Day song that most of you in this room will know if you've listened to any kind of Christian music the last 10, 15, 20 years. Chris Tomlin, Good, Good Father. Let's sing this together. If you don't know it, learn it today. It's a very singable and beautiful song.
Oh, I've heard thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Oh, when I've seen many searching for answers, far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you.
A decade, but we're going straight to the Bats game because it's fathers throw to their children on the field after the game, and I've been invited by someone to go to that. So we're pretty much going straight. So the sermon will be really short today. Everybody just clap for that. We'll be late to the game. Hey, there were some claps. Wait a minute. That's just fine. That's good. So we do need to pray. I know they were coming, and then I don't know what's happened. I know everybody has a power out in the area. I know Casey and Amanda, he's the first one that texted me this morning that the power was out. He's having surgery June 30th, gallbladder laparoscopic. So he's had a lot of discomfort and pain, and found out Friday that he will have that surgery. So
really,
you feel for him. Diane is back, and let's just clap for Diane being back. She just had surgery. And if you saw Diane when she had that pain, I mean, she was like this just the whole time in the hospital. Awful. And Pam's been there for sure. Harriet's been there. You all have a special secret handshake about gallbladders. Be sure to show Casey if he comes today. You ladies surround him, lay hands on him in prayer, because it's not good. But it is going to be laparoscopic, so that's hopefully good with that. And June 30th is the date. So we'll just throw that out there, and hopefully he will get relief. He has quite a few health issues, and hopefully this will help with a lot of them. So now I'll open up to you all for needs. We just said, look, Diane is back. She's just had her surgery, and this is her first time back. And I know that she was able to have a lot of you all come see her and bring her something to eat. was real good. I have an update on our other folks that we had the food train, and I'll get you, Troy. Timmy Jones texted me as we were on Drennon Road. Somehow I received it. That was a miracle in itself. And since my phone is on a tripod, I wrote down what it said. This is an update on Timmy and Taylor. He said, "We won't be able to make it today, you think? But baby Buck is doing great, already gaining his weight back. And Taylor is doing awesome as well. We're both still wore out, but finally getting caught back up on sleep." So you all will see a food train clipboard come around about that for this coming week in a moment. And her sister Allie is coordinating family for the week after next. So our food train for Timmy and Taylor will be this week only, starting tomorrow and proceeding through next Sunday. And then surrounding family will take over from that.
So, speaking of, there are containers by the table from some of the other meal trains. Look at the box and see that it's your container.
It could have been from the funeral meals, could be from the food trains, because you got used for it. All right, Troy, what'd you have?
We had Louis Powell on our prayer list for a long time before he passed away a few days ago.
Very sorry for that. Louis Powell. All right. Who else do we need to bring up today? Barb.
Her request for my mom traveling. She's in Iowa. And praises that Manny is home. But he is as grumpy as ever and can't get around. And so mom and Heather are both having a hard time, keeping him happy.
And Gene may be there a while, right?
I don't know.
There's no agenda right
I've
now.
I've got a dog.
You've got a dog. Who's got cancer?
Actually, she's visiting the other grandparents.
There you go. All right. Good deal. That's right. I knew about that. More prayer needs, requests. Amanda.
Haley Lynch. Mm-hmm. I mentored her as a teenager. She's in her early 20s and was kicked by a horse at her job. So she's having some pretty serious pain from nerve damage in her ankle.
We have some horse folks in this building, so nerve damage in our ankle, so we kick. Haley Lynch. Thank you. Who else today? First, we will mention the power outage. It's not just, right now it's not dead of winter, thank goodness, but that does affect a lot of things, and I hope it comes back if it hasn't already. For those of us in the church family.
Someone said that their car was locked in the garage and couldn't get out. I said, I'll have pictures. I've heard about
it. All right. Do they live anywhere nearby, or are they calling from Indiana? Or
Ohio? Carlos, I think it's
okay.
Good, but I think
all
right.
We're turned on. We really didn't get down there right now. So somebody head down that way, whoever it is, quickly.
Someone says they can't hear the pastor.
Well, are they rejoicing in that fact, or they want me to turn it up? I feel like I'm pretty loud, so okay. Well, hopefully that'll remedy itself. Go Reds! Yeah, and one time in a million, then it's something you can be proud of for half a minute.
But no prayer requests.
No prayer requests. Just snide comments. Great. Good. Glad we're so spiritual here. That's fantastic. Yeah. Got our priorities right. Are there any other prayer requests from anybody about anything within the church? All right, let's have a quiet time, and then we will have corporate prayer together. Our good, good Father, we pray for those mentioned today, for Casey Jeffries, who does know his surgery day. Let that go well, let that be a relief. Praises for Diane getting back from that same thing. Prayers for Haley Lynch with this damage in her ankle, nerve damage from being kicked by a horse. Got a lot of folks in this room right now that love horses and work with them daily. For the family of Louis Powell, who's passed away, been on the prayer list a lot. For Jean Lewis, traveling to be around her son, who has had this bad accident, Danny Lewis, and recuperating now. And so Traveling Mercies, Jean in Iowa with family, and as long as she will be there. And for all of our other needs that are unspoken, unmentioned, a lot of them long term. It's in the name of Jesus we do pray. Amen. Before we really go into the other announcements and celebrations, there is a really nice picture we can. Yeah, you can say aw. That's pretty good. If you all have seen him at all in up close pictures, he looks like Timmy. Oh my goodness. He sure does. He looks like Taylor too, of course. But when we saw him at the hospital, he's little Timmy Mayo, for sure. And they are so sweet with that baby. My goodness, they've been waiting for that baby a while. Been through some tragedy. Glad to have him.
So. No one is going to be full
ride. No way. Full ride? No way. No way. Should be and will be, and that's praise God for that. Need to read some thank you cards for a lot of things that are happening. I've been handed these throughout the week and received them in the mail and everything else. This one's from Diane. Special thank you. Every kindness has a part in bringing joy to someone's heart. It's easy sometimes to forget that there are nice people out there doing nice things for others. Thanks for being a special reminder. I would like to thank everyone for their prayers, cards, and visits to the hospital. It was so much appreciated. Love, Diane. She's right here. This one's from Miss Linda, who suffered the loss of her sister last week. Thank you, church family, for the beautiful wind chimes. My sister's homecoming celebration was beautiful. All the family were together in her church. Silas Baptist Church served a banquet at the Methodist Church as they were having VBS in theirs. That's what Christians do, lift each other up in a time of need. Thank you for your prayers and texts. They were received loud and clear. You are a loving congregation, and you demonstrate your love in many acts of kindness. Stephen Linda Pompiak. This one is from Stephanie Miskell Nutter and family, Jeannie's daughter, and cousin and niece to many in this church. To all of Mom's church family, thank you so much for all the prayers, messages, shares, etc. during Mom's final days with us. I appreciate you all taking her in and giving her a place of comfort and respite this last few years. Knowing she had that was also a great source of comfort to me. I appreciate the gift of the wind chime and especially want to thank you for the fantastic dinner after Mom's service. You have a lot of great cooks in your congregation. Words truly cannot express the thanks and gratitude I have for each of you. But please know I appreciate and thank you from the bottom of my heart. Stephanie Miskell Nutter and family. And then lastly, we have one from Andrea, the Holder family. Says, Dear Drennon Christian Church, thank you for our church family for all the ways you have blessed our family over the last few weeks. During our times of rejoicing and celebration, we have grateful hearts that we have a family in Christ to share the good times and the hard times. We are most thankful for all the prayer support, but we have one to also express our appreciation for the gifts, cards, and support for Bridget upon her graduation, as well as the sweet help with the meals provided after Sawyer returned home from his delivery. Thanks to all for the gifts for him as well. Ephesians 1:16, I have not stopped giving thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers. With love, the Holder family. So congregation, that's what it's about. Care on, love on people, and meet them where they are and where they have need. I'm going to do some celebrations now. This is Sunday, June 18th, and we have some celebrations to have. We don't have a birthday listed for this week, but I happen to know we have a frequent visitor in our congregation who her birthday is today, and her good friend shared online that it was her birthday, so she happens to be here today. So. A member of our Lord Help Us band, Miss Jessica Mays Lyons, has her birthday today, and we can thank Chris for that.
Thank you, Chris.
I'm sure you'll be thanked very well later on for that. Do we have any other birthdays today or this week in the congregation? Oh, Jessica gets it all to herself. All right. I'm going to sing happy birthday, dear Jessica. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jessica.
happy birthday to you.
And pray for Chris. Today's Timmy and Taylor's anniversary. We sang to them. What an anniversary, and what a Father's Day for them. It couldn't be any better. And I'm glad they checked in with us, let us know that they weren't coming today. We knew that. But it means a lot when you do let us know you're not going to be here. All right, things that are happening. This week we're on Amos chapter 8. We've been in an Old Testament book that is timely and relevant and about today. It's crazy. So if you've not been coming to Bible study on Wednesday night, why not? We had two ladies in this room who came last Wednesday night for the first time. It was really cool. And gives you goosebumps when you see somebody come in that door that hadn't been on Wednesday night before. Do it. This coming Saturday, we have a picnic at Kathy Walling's house. Kathy, what would you like?
Everybody come, bring a friend, bring a chair, bring a side if you're so inclined. Not, don't have to, but come out, enjoy a good time, have some good food, and just fellowship with everybody.
Everybody's invited.
Everybody's invited.
There is a paper, and we'll start those going around. I know most of you have seen them, but.
The mail train, too, if you've done it.
Yeah. Let me just go ahead and.
And it's from 3 to 7.
Recommence the meeting of
whatever time you want to come, whatever time you want to leave.
And then she make sure that Kathy ends up with her picnic list so she'll know.
Yeah. All right, so here they are. Kathy's paper is on the same clipboard as Timmy Taylor and Buck's meal train. So Kathy's has a lot of information on it already. She needs to end up with this paper to go home with her today. So let's make sure if she forgets, let somebody else not forget. She needs to have this paper. This one. For Timmy and Taylor, last week we signed up for meals for Diane and for Sawyer's family. So if you signed up for one last week, please wait until everybody else has a chance. Because some of you didn't, because we didn't have enough slots. We only had like 11 slots for last week. There's a lot more people than that. So when this comes to you, fill it out if you didn't get to, if you had the chance to. This is 1 week of food to Taylor and Timmy, who live right up there. They live next door to Junie B. Hart. So top of the hill, take a left on Maddox Ridge, they're right there. And her phone number's on here, and just ask them about what they're, you know, they said no dietary restrictions, no pickiness, bring it on. But still call them so you can coordinate what time. We'll start that here. And then lastly, the other one is about the church directory. I have printed the update. So if you gave updated information or added yourself to the directory, that is in here. If you want a new picture, please circle it and say, I'll give you a new picture. I have a few of the pictures in here that have a yellow border around them. They're ones that we know we have to update, like Timmy and Taylor, we want Buck. Rashay, Patrick, and Wesley, we want Sawyer. And a couple of you said, we'll give you a new picture. So if you're not in the directory and want to be, we have a page in the back. This is your information. Those of you that have already done that, you're in the directory now. But we need pictures of you. So we'll start this one on the other side. Yes, sir.
I have plenty of CDs to play plenty of music during the day also, but if you have a guitar, banjo, harmonica, whatever instrument you want to bring it along.
How about if you play a comb with a piece of toilet paper?
That's fine. I don't care.
Bring it on.
I like music, so.
Good deal. All right, we had the First Steps class today. We had more people today than we had last week, which is really cool. Next week's the last one, talking about being part of this church, maybe a new member of this church, joining a church for the first time, being baptized, all that. Come next Sunday, 10 o'clock. That'll be the last meeting. Next Sunday is also, right after worship, a board meeting. If you don't know that you're on the board or don't remember it, look on the back, okay? The list is here, and since it's a new board that just started in March, it's easy to forget. Elders are always invited and encouraged to attend for your wisdom and your leadership as the men who've been appointed to lead the church. So next Sunday, right after worship. Also next Sunday, right after worship, unless something changes there, at the same time, we have a softball track. Softball is going to start Tuesday, July 11th. Yeah, that's here, isn't it? League of Seven Churches. So next Sunday, JR will have a practice at Harry Hill Park. We'll start on probably field 3, the one closest to the highway. And come if you can, because the games will be here before we know it. Other things that are on here, we have one more baby shower. It's in July 16th. You see that listed here? The same day that we have that night of karaoke. It's going to be crazy. It's crazy. And that's the week after our baptism day. You'll hear more about that soon. Any other announcements need to be made by anybody that's not me, please? That's a lot. All right. We don't have someone signed up for the children's message today. Come see me. Harriet? Are they here? Oh, good. I want to be reminded. I think Miss Nellie has watermelon plants.
Yes, I do.
If you want watermelon plants, you got way too many. See Miss Nellie Hayden about watermelon plant. We want one. See, you want one, Ambrosia? All right, do we have another bid from the back? All right, watermelon plants for Nellie. All right, bring on. All right, Andrea, she'll take two. Okay, that's fine. All right, see Nellie after worship. Children's message, give us one. Our kids deserve it. We have some things in the works that are going to be very good, but we need to have it flowing. Men or women, boys or girls, if you have a message, share it. Let's go see each other for fellowship time. Shake a hand. See a baby. Don't scare them. Commiserate with Chris for giving up his dear friend Jessica's birthday. All that stuff. Thank you. listen to that bell. Is it just because Cambry and Kinsley didn't ring it today? And they like them, yeah. They're very aggressive with them. Yeah. Carrie, I'd also like to open up the flags if anybody needs a flag. Any of you men did not get a flag? If you want to take a flag to somebody that needs a flag that is online or at home, Crystal wants one, Harriet. Amen to that. That's why we had those flags. We got plenty more. Chris, Tara, take one back to Chris. You're a daddy. He gave his to Jim Atkinson, which is a good move, but he gets one too. All right, we got a couple things before we go into communion time. One, I was told during fellowship time, a prayer need we need to have. I don't have a name, but I have a concern. Harold and Trish Barton were in, JR's dad and stepmom. And while Harold and Trish were here, Trish was extremely distraught because her brother, she just lost a brother a year or two ago, but another of her brothers had was to the point of almost death, decisions to be made because of an accident he had. But as of yesterday, a brain bleed. As of yesterday, they're transferring him from hospice to hospital. And he's awake and aware and doing great. And that is miraculous. We'll get a name and put him on the prayer list. But yes, let's clap for Trish's brother. She was down here to have a fun time in Kentucky, go to the Grand Ole Opry, and she spent it worrying sick about her brother who had an accident. Just crazy, but doing better.
And also, just on that same day, can we bring up Jean Parsons?
We have a date now, don't we?
We do. Well, 2 days. July 7th, Jean Parsons will be having a CT scan and all the other tests. But anyway, then she'll actually do open heart surgery.
The 12th, isn't it?
July.
Yeah.
So pray for Jean.
Yeah, she's on the list. I didn't bring her up. We need to be in prayer. Trish Barton's brother will get the name. And for Jean Parsons. Her date for surgery is coming up.
And continue for Regina Piles, too. She hasn't been here. She's been struggling with health and, just family issues, different things.
Yep. She's being pulled in many directions. We have talked with her, and several of you have talked with her. She'd really like to be here. One more presentation. We got so much of this stuff going on. At least I remember the birthdays, right? I mean, it's been 3 weeks in a row I haven't until somebody said,
Lord's Prayer.
Birthdays, Lord's Prayer. And new members in our church, we've had that a lot lately, and it's great. And made a certificate of membership this week to Terry and Patricia Brown. So they joined our church last week. If you weren't here, I want to bring that to them. Full voting rights, members of the church, and they checked this out a long time before they came to this place, and glad they did. So, there you go. My wife's looking at you with a phone. That's kind of awkward, isn't it? There you go. Yeah, that's how it works, I guess. All right, Holy Communion. We were talking about it this morning in our First Steps class, and what's that mean? Why does Drennon do that every week? Well, it says so in Scripture. When we come to meet together, we are to take Holy Communion. To remember what he has done for us, Jesus Christ, his sacrifice for us. The bread that you'll take, cracker. It means his body was broken for you, for me, for all of us, for everybody, whether they accept it or believe it or not. And the juice that comes around, whether the church that you're at does wine or juice, or if you're at home and you use root beer, that little cup, that little drink, signifies the blood that he shed for you, for me, for us, for all. As you take of it today, let it mean that. Don't just take it out of a habit. Take it. We're going to prepare with a hymn today, and the hymn is the Solid Rock. It's where I want to put my faith, on that solid rock. Let's do the first and last verse, 293, if you'd like to follow in the book. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but only lean on
we always come here and do this to honor Jesus Christ, except for on the cross, but he had his suffering with the disciples. And we are able to do this to recognize him as his suffering and his death on the cross. So as we take this, let's remember that we did this to honor and remember Jesus Christ.
You'll remember our offering in the back and the plate and online. Folks, there's quite a few that have been checking in with the church this morning online. You can send your tithes and offerings to Drennon Christian Church, P.O. Box 495, Newcastle, Kentucky, 40050. And let's stand together with Wesley for the doxology.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below.
you for the blessing of the meal, for the fellowship we have together. Sometimes it's hard to stop and come sit back down. We love to see each other. And bless us through your holy word, the Bible. In the name of Jesus, we do pray. Amen. You may be seated. And I look at the screen after I was told how many people are here. And last year we had it the same week, 44. And that was a little below average that week last year. We averaged about 55 on the year. Today we have 65. And we have several families out. And you know who they are. Because a lot of you ask, well, where's that one? Where's that one? There's that one. And they're out today. Including one that couldn't get her car out of the garage. Hopefully we can remedy that. But anyway, a lot of folks. And if everybody were here, we'd probably be having about 80. Maybe a little bit more. I told you back last September that I could see a time when we're averaging over 100. And I want to do that. I think we can. If we get everybody in the building on 1 week, it would be great. And have a lot of folks. But speaking of that, new members. Long-time members. Young folks. Old folks. These are some things we've had this spring and summer. Births and funerals. Times of celebration. Times we feel under attack. Rejoicing in the saving truth that we know. Lamenting the falsehoods we see in the world, even in churches sometimes. It almost feels like I'm reading from Ecclesiastes. There's a time to be born, there's a time to die, because there's a lot of back and forth. You know, this spring and this summer have been a rejoicing time in a lot of ways when we have a baptism week planned. And we have new members. When I've had to give lots of receipts to Barb as our treasurer for ordering more Bibles. I mean, those are good things. But we've had to also look at not only the passing away of a member of our church, who's also a member of a lot of your all's family, biologically. But I can tell you, and some of you know that with being part of a church, there's attacks too. And sometimes you might feel, as a Christian or as the Christian in your family, that people don't want to hear it. They want you to keep that to yourself. Don't talk about it. Don't bother us with that. Harriet and I, as a pastor family, we get that some too. And we know that we, on the front lines, are going to have more attacks per capita. And we do. And that's fine. We wouldn't trade it. But through all that, through the ups and downs, through the positives and the negatives, through the births and the funerals, through the beautiful babies and the space where we should have a wheelchair where someone should be sitting right now, we have a model to look at in Scripture for how the church should look. We don't have it figured out here, okay? There's some days that we feel pretty good about how the church is doing, and you might say, well, when I walk in those doors, I feel like I experience Jesus. I know the Holy Spirit's alive because the way I feel with the people that I love in this building, I feel like He's radiating through. But we need a model to stay on track, to stay on course, because if we don't have that, if we leave it to our own devices, you know we're going to fail. You know we're going to backslide. You know we're going to do things we shouldn't do. Because we're human, and we have not arrived, and we will not arrive until He comes and gets us, takes us into the air with the dead in Christ first. We join Jesus in the air, and we go off to His glory. Until that point, we'll muddle through. This place I'm telling you to look at, to study, to emulate, to strive toward. Victor led us through a few minutes of it in the beginning of the service and the call to worship, and it is the end of Acts chapter 2. And I'm going to read just 6 short verses, and I tried to find a picture that encapsulated it. The one on your bulletin and the one on the screen is that. It's a group of people sitting around a table, breaking bread together, men and women, boys and girls. I see a baby. I see food. I see smiles and laughter. And honestly, that picture reminds us of us sometimes. It's real good. Let's read the story. Starting in verse 42. And I'll tell you, this verse has been on my heart in my brain and my study more in the last several years than most verses. Just one. Acts 2:42, look at it. It says, they devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and the fellowship, to the breaking of bread, and to prayer. Now, those are the words that happened right after it said Peter's sermon where 3,000 people were baptized that day, the day of Pentecost. Jesus arose from the grave and ascended to heaven just a few scant weeks prior. Here we have the model of the young and early church. And I was saying in the class this morning, 10 o'clock, first steps, and I said it last week too, that this church, Drennon Christian Church, or Drennon Springs Chapel as it used to be called, was founded by a movement 200 years ago that wanted to hearken back to that. Even 200 years ago, around 1800, folks in America, and specifically in Paris, Kentucky, where this began, were already seeing that we were straying away from the church. We were more about ourselves, we were more about tradition, more about rituals than we were about what it says in the Bible. So this was a verse that was very important to them back then. Now, we were part of that movement, we were part of that denomination for a good while, until even folks in that movement decided to leave the Bible behind and go crazy. And I like to say it's a terrible phrase, but they went woke before woke was cool. And so we left and decided our denomination would be this. I think it served us okay. But this is what they did. Look, it says they devoted. In your estimation, do you as a Christian devote yourself to the apostles' teaching? So these early folks were already looking to the guys and gals that were around Jesus. Do you look to their teaching, namely collected here, as your devotion? Do you trust that? Do you study that? Do you prayerfully consider that on a day-to-day basis? Are you devoted to it? It says they were devoted to fellowship. Sometimes I think that might be one that we might do best. Again, I rang the bell at the end of the fellowship time and not a soul moved. I mean, it was wild. And I know there's babies in the room, and that's pretty good. And that's not all our babies. Last week we had some other toddlers in the room, and there's more babies. Hopefully we'll get to meet Buck here pretty soon, and that's going to be pretty strong. We got one more baby due in the church in August, and that's really good. So we fellowship, and we meet each other. It's not just about the babies. Don't get me wrong. But it's about, I haven't seen them for a while. I know she hasn't felt well. I want to talk to her. I want to hug them because they're a good hugger. Or I know what she's gone through. I need to make sure she knows I'm here. Fellowship. Yeah. Breaking of bread. You know, we broke bread here. We had the communion time. That's a small meal that is very, very important. But we break bread in other ways too, don't we? Somebody in this room, I don't know who, is going to take food to Taylor and Timmy and Bob Jones tomorrow. I guess we'll find out when we see the clipboard come through. We eat on Wednesday nights. Sometimes we have time to fit in the Bible. We do. We eat a lot. Some of you stopped coming at 6 because there's too much food. They come at 6:30. That's fine. That's fine. And then to prayer. Sometimes I think that's the one we need to work on the most. We have prayer warriors in this room. We pray during the service as well. But we can never, ever say we pray enough. I'm sorry, we can't. Moving in the story, it says, everyone was filled with awe at the many wonders and signs performed by the apostles. Now I want to ask you about that relating to your Christian walk right now. Are you filled with awe by your faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Or is it just kind of a, I hope not. I hear less and less of that. Now I know that I've said in this pulpit, and a lot of you have even mentioned this same kind of term, and we talk about it even on the phone, some of us, about professional churchgoers or cultural Christians. Maybe you've been there before. I know I've been there before too, where you're just going through the motions. You know, yeah, I'm in church, bro. What do you want? Man, I got that. I'm there. Now, they were having many wonders and signs performed. Do we require that? I hope not. Sometimes we can get to the point where, well, I'm going to go to that different church because, man, have you heard their music? Whoa! Now, our music's better than it's been. You know, we not only have three or four great pianists, keyboard players in the church, but we have a band, we got people who sing, we have musical guests. Those things are great, but that's not what it's about. It's got to be about the awe you feel because you have a risen Savior who is your Lord, and you want to devote yourself to Him. Period. It says all the believers were together and had everything in common. There's one we can work on. Since we're human, and I think last time I checked, we all are, you have issues, I have issues, we all have issues. Will there be a moment when we're all together in one accord? I don't know. But when we stand up and say the Lord's Prayer together, when we take communion together, when we have our closing benediction prayer at the end of the service, those are little glimpses to me of heaven. We are all of one accord. Even if we've been terribly distracted during the hour of worship, we have something going on in our lives, or we know we have to get home for something, or our car can't get out of our garage, we can't focus on Him. But they were together and had everything in common. Now, that everything in common part, do you believe the same? Are you making sure that the people in this church body that are your people, the ones that you're the closest friends with, the ones that you're neighbors with, the ones that you are part of their biological family even, or adopted family, are you making sure that they're believing in Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior? Are you making sure that they understand what it means to be part of a church? You know and I know it's not anything that Harriet and I can handle alone, or that the elders can handle alone, or the Sunday school teachers or the board. It's about relationships. The people that you put your arm around, are you checking in on them? Because here it says they had everything in common. Next part says they sold property and possessions to give to anyone who had need. That's tough, isn't it? That's real tough. And in today's materialistic society where we want more and more and more and better and better and better and newer and newer and newer, sometimes we don't think enough about giving away and doing what should be done for people who are in need. We've been reading a lot in the book of Amos, in this time in the 700s BC, where the Jewish folk were doing so well financially, prospering in their everyday lives, that they were forgetting about their God. They were going through the motions in their synagogue or church life. And it was having a trickle-down effect on their faith. Now, don't think we don't have that problem in America. Now, I know we live in a place right now, we're not in inner city Detroit or Chicago, we're out in God's country, amen to that, but we can be distracted too. Give to people in need. So every day they continue to meet together in the temple courts. I told you we had 65 people today. If we had everybody who counts themselves a member of this church, counts themselves as this is their church family in this room all together, it would be at least 80, probably closer to 90. You know, we've had years where we've had 65 or 70 if everybody was in the same room. You know, we had 132 here on Easter. Now, not all those folks were members. Some were your family members. Some were visitors checking in. But you know that if all of us were together, we'd be averaging a good 80. Let's get to that. Because it said here, they continued to meet together in the temple courts every day. Since I retired a year ago plus, I'd love being down here. I'd love to do more during the week here. Have things where people could come together. We need to work on that. We need your ideas. We had a new member this morning say, hey, I'm a new member and they're embracing me and my gifts and what I have and what I bring to the church. And yeah, let's talk together about what you have to offer for this church. Not to offer, that's a terrible word, but of you. So that we can do more things together. Says they broke bread in their homes and ate together with glad and sincere hearts. They're part of each other's lives. We tell you to honk twice when you pass our house, and there's some of you that do it all the time. And I try to honk when I pass your house too. If you ever wonder who that weird honk was from, it's probably me. We know where you live. You know where we live. But we need to be together. Be together. And it says they were praising God, enjoying the favor of all the people. Now that's a ripple effect too. They weren't necessarily worried about pleasing all the people. If we worry about pleasing all the people, we'll end up being not a church, or a church that goes with the tides of the times, where we just want to do whatever makes us look good on Twitter. Who cares about that? If we do that, we're going to spiral. But because they were praising God, that radiated out. Someone said this morning in our First Steps class, it's just about you're being different because you have the Holy Spirit. There's something about you that is different because Jesus lives in your heart. People will see that, and you will enjoy the favor of all the people. Now, you might counter with that saying, well, nobody likes that right now, preacher. Haven't you watched the news? Oh, I know. A lot of people don't like that. They don't want to hear about Jesus. They don't want to see that you're different because of the Holy Spirit. They want to make that go away. They want that to be hidden under a bushel because that doesn't fit their narrative. But I'm telling you, there are more and more people, and you know it, who want to see what Jesus brings into a life. And if they see that through you, you might be that difference. You might not, but you might. They enjoyed the favor of all the people. And the last words of this are big. It says, and the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. Now look at that away from a church term. If you look at that just from the perspective of a church, you might think, oh, well, their numbers are growing. Well, they can put different numbers up there. Might have to put a one in front of it. No, no. Don't worry about that. And also the word saved, you think, have you been saved, brother? Have you gone down in the water? I don't even mean that. Think about the fact of their life has been saved by the fact that if we know and believe what is true in this book, that if you do not know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, your eternity is not just annihilation where you don't feel or know anything and you're just dead. No, it's that you will suffer torment in the depths of hell because you refuse or turn your back on the salvation offered to you by Jesus Christ, the only way. So people were being saved from that. And I guarantee you know, and I know too, people that their eternal outcome right now is probably not on the positive side of the ledger. I hope and pray that everybody that we know and love can get to know Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior. I certainly hope and pray that everyone who walks through these doors, that door, this door, or anywhere on this campus, know Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior. You all help each other make sure of that so that you know that anybody in here has someone come and approach them and make friends with them and sit with them and make them comfortable to the point where you have a relationship so we can find out, because it says here to be saved. And if that happens, yeah, our church will grow. But mainly, any church that has a Bible being taught will grow. And we need to make sure of that so that wherever you drive on a Sunday or a Saturday in Henry County and beyond, those little church parking lots are full, and they're having to lay more gravel or more blacktop. Not because of us, because of Him. Picture there at the bottom of the same scripture I just had, and the Lord added to their number daily those who are being saved. July 9th, 3 weeks from today, is a symbol of that. We spoke a lot this morning together about, in the First Steps class, about the fact that it's not magic water. I've told you from this pulpit, and I said in that class as well this morning, that it has broken my heart many times over the last 6 or 7 years. We baptized about 60 people in this church during that time period since Rick and Vicki were baptized on those steps. A lot of the folks that have been baptized are here or in the church where they're a member. Probably close to half of them are nowhere. That pains me. And I hope it pains you. Because of misunderstanding, not getting the fact that when you are baptized, when you join a church, when you accept Jesus into your heart, you are not saying, I'm done. You're saying, let's go. Let's begin. Let's get a start. And I hope and pray that when we baptize Timmy in a few weeks, and maybe others will be there that day as well, that they're like, All right, now let's get started. We're ready to go, aren't we? We've got baptized. That's right, Victor. And we're going to go do it. Not the, well, I've been baptized. I'm done. We're good. Go talk about church with me. Okay, we're not going there. Why is that? Why don't you want to go there? Francis Chan had a quote. Last thing I'm going to say, I wrote it down. I hadn't listened to Francis in a while, and I came across him the other day. Francis Chan, a pastor who's traveled the world and who I've enjoyed several of his books. We did one of his books here called Letters to the Church. Francis said in a sermon I listened to while mowing last week, it said, I want to enter your kingdom, but I don't want you as king. Think about that. Now, he doesn't mean that. He's saying that's what a lot of people say right now. You want to go to heaven. Yes, sir, I do. If you look at it as God's kingdom, yeah, I want to go to your kingdom, but I do not want you as king. I'll take heaven, but leave the God part out. Or as I've said a lot lately, and you've heard me especially on Wednesday nights, maybe Sunday mornings too, I want Jesus as my Savior, but not as my Lord. Mm-mm. He can pull me out of the depths of hell, but that's it. I'm good. No. It's not for me to judge. It's not for you to judge. It's not for anybody but him to judge. So we won't. Shudder to think if we did. But I will teach from this pulpit. Show the people that you know and love who are dabbling in Christianity that it's a journey. It's a process. And it's a lifelong movement towards him. We don't arrive at a point where we're done. Till he takes us, calls us home one way or another. We're going to stand and have an invitation right now. This is the invitation. We've had a lot of folks come down lately on this hymn. This is my Father's world on Father's Day. It's his world. If you want to join him where he happens to have a house of the Lord at Drennon Springs, then do that at this time. If you want to be part of that baptism on July 9th, proclaim it. But let's stand together and sing. This is my Father's world.
This is my Father's world, and to my listening ears, all nature sings and round me rings the music of the spheres. This is my Father's world. I rest me in the thought of rocks and trees, of skies and seas, his hands the wonders wrought. This is my Father's world. The birds their carols raise, the morning light, the lily white, declare their Maker's praise. This is my Father's world. He shines in all that's fair. In the rustling grass I hear him pass. He speaks to me everywhere. This is my Father's world. Oh, let me ne'er forget that though the wrong seems oft so strong, God is the ruler yet. This is my Father's world. The battle is not done. Jesus, who died, shall be satisfied, and earth and heaven be one.
Let's gather on the outside of the pews to have our benediction prayer.
us, protect us all, keep us all safe as we leave this building, but carry your church with us. Lord, I just pray all this to you in your holy and precious name, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.